Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the .NET MAUI Dataform control. The Syncfusion .NET MAUI Dataform control is used to facilitate the creation and editing of data forms for various business purposes, such as login, reservation, contact, and employee forms. In this video, I will show you how to add the Dataform control to a .NET MAUI application and bind data. I will also demonstrate how to change the form layout and editor type and apply validation. Before you begin, make sure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. Once you have installed the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application and provide a project name and location. Here, I'll proceed to create the project with the .NET 7.0 framework. Now the project is ready. Before I move forward, let's take a quick detour to set up the environment for running our application. Here, I choose an Android emulator. For this demonstration, I will select the Pixel 5 Android emulator. Once the emulator is selected, I'll run the application and show you the default output. The application has started compiling the default code, so let's wait for a few seconds. And now the application's homepage is displayed. Next, I will show you how to incorporate a Syncfusion.NET MAUI Dataform into this application. First, I open the NuGet Package Manager. Search for the Syncfusion MAUI Dataform package and install it in my application. It will take a few seconds to complete the installation. Once the package is installed, I need to register the Syncfusion core handler to map the cross-platform API to the native Vue API. So, open the MAUI program file and add Syncfusion MAUI core hosting. Then register the handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method. To use the Syncfusion MAUI controls, it is necessary to register a trial license key. I do this by opening the app.xaml.cs file. Add the register license method and enter the trial license key. To find out where to generate the trial license key, you'll find a link to instructions in the description below. Next, I navigate to the main XAML page and remove the default scroll view related code. Then, I import the Syncfusion MAUI Dataform namespace. And to the local XML namespace, map the default project namespace, MAUI project. Then I initialize the control by adding the SF Dataform tag. Since this is a data edit control, I need to bind the data object based on the form requirements. To demonstrate this, I'm going to use the MVVM pattern. First, I create a model class and name it Employee Info. Now the class is created, it needs to make public. Then, I define the field first name of the type string. And then add other fields such as middle name, last name, and so on, with their appropriate types. I am going to initialize these fields. So, create another class view model. Now the class is created, it needs to make public. I declare a bindable property, employee of type employee info class. Inside the constructor, I will initialize the employee property. On the main XAML page, I add the binding context property. And assign the local view model class. And then assign the bindable property employee to the data object property. Let me run this application by pressing the F5 key. See, now the data form is rendered based on the provided data object. And you can edit the form fields. You can also have the floating label layout by adding the layout type property and setting its value to text input layout. Check now, each field in the data form is changed to the floating label layout. Next, I will show you the built-in editor types in data form. By default, editors will be loaded based on primitive data types such as string, enumeration, datetime, and timespan. Notice here, a date picker renders for the date joined field and a checkbox for the confirmed field. The editor types available are text, multiline, password, and so on. To know more about the complete list, you can refer to the documentation link provided in the description below. I will explain a very basic one now and cover the other important types in my upcoming video. In this form, I plan to render a multiline editor for the address column. To do that, I open the employee info class and set the data type to multiline text for the address column. See now, I can enter an address in multiple lines. Finally, I'll show you basic validations in the data form. In the employee info class, I add validation for the first name field, name should not be empty. And contact number should not exceed 10 digits for the contact number field. Look here, validation is applied for the first name and contact number fields. In this video, I have shown you how to create a .NET MAUI application and add the Syncfusion MAUI Dataform control with a few of its basic features. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, giving you a free license key to use all our .NET MAUI products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.